In Amsterdam, there is a man with the profound ability to withstand cold, and he's not a monk. His name is Wim Hof. But they call him the Iceman.
When I was 17, 18, 90 years, I felt empty, spiritually empty. And I could not find a fulfillment for that. And I looked in many traditions, many countries, many languages, but I couldn't find it. I think cold is a noble force, and I can compete with it and learn from it and get to places in myself, in consciousness and feeling, which I would not have been able to get to.
It was over 20 years ago that Wim first discovered his powers against the cold.
One day I was walking by the park. I really got attracted by the water with a layer of ice on it. It looked like, I don't know. You know, sometimes you cannot describe it, but you know, it's beautiful. When I got into the water, I really felt a mighty feeling coming over me, and after 30 seconds, I felt great. Then I think that's one of my first moments where my mind got still. No side effects anymore, no thoughts anymore, just feeling. After this experience, I found out there is a Tummo technique, which is inner fire, exercised by monks, Tibetan monks in the Himalayas. And I really got into that and began to learn from them and to practice it. And I saw I could do it too. Right now, I'm focused from within. So I feel strong and warm. A power is inside, like an energy.
Wim has learned to harness his powers to test the limits of what flesh and blood can stand. In recent years, Wim has achieved some of the most remarkable feats of human endurance. In 2005, Wim squared off with the bitter cold of Finland by running a half marathon barefoot in the snow. He is the first person to attempt such a feat in the Arctic Circle. 3 months later, he climbed the slopes of Mount Everest wearing only shorts to a stunning altitude of 22,500 feet. And most recently, he set a new world record for cold endurance. For 1 hour and 12 minutes, he sat motionless in direct contact with ice. But he didn't achieve these abilities overnight. It's taken years of practice.
What I do is lethal to a normal person, because a normal person is absolutely not trained to do this. It'll damage the body. It's not conditioned to withstand that cold.
Now an international superstar, Wim holds 13 world records for his superhuman accomplishments. But not every stunt goes well. Last year in Finland, Wim finally faced death. He was attempting to swim 50 meters under Arctic ice. The water temperature was just below freezing, cold enough to send most people into shock instantly. Half the distance to the finish, Wim's eyes froze over. Unable to see the exit hole, he was forced to hold his breath for several minutes while trapped under the ice. He was seconds away from death, but suddenly, a diver grabbed his leg and pulled him to safety. Wim's ability to hold his breath for prolonged periods saved his life that day. And scientists are discovering his Tummo practice may have altered his body's chemistry in completely unexpected ways.
Scientists have been running a test on me that could be an answer to many, many diseases.
His greatest achievements may be yet to come. Wim Hof has spent his life training his mind to overcome his body's physical limits.
Sometimes I'm sitting for hours in the freezer and there is no problem because at a certain point it just changes my physiology.
To prove that his physical feats are the result of his meditative process, Wim volunteered to allow scientists to monitor him as he went into a deep state of TUMO. What they found was a complete surprise. Blood tests revealed that he is creating an unusually high amount of antibodies, proteins that help fight infection from bacteria and viruses.
Scientists have been running a test on me and drew blood before, while, and after my meditation. And I found out that there were antibodies developed while I was meditating. Not before, while I was meditating.
Our brains contain a dozen cranial nerves that control our bodily functions. Considered the most important, the vagus nerve regulates heart rate, blood pressure, and body temperature. Through meditation, Wim has proven his ability to control these involuntary functions. But scientists now speculate the vagus nerve also regulates the body's immune system, and it's possible that Wim has learned how to control this as well. If true, he could potentially heal himself from certain infections and diseases like arthritis.
If this goes on and it shows that I'm able to, by meditation to develop antibodies in my blood and pass it on, this ability, to others, that could be an answer to many, many diseases.
As a medical profession, using these altered states, from my point of view, can bring about better health and well-being, perhaps to prevent disease.
The Iceman is living proof of mind over matter. And pushing the envelope of what the human body can do is Wim Hof's all-encompassing passion. Next year, Wim is attempting another amazing feat.
My next challenge is the Antarctic in shorts, barefooted, running a full marathon. I'm scared like everybody, and that's in the beginning, but I've learned how to get over it. To be scared is very natural, because it shows something dangerous is happening, you should be prepared. So when I'm prepared, then this fear will go away. Then I know I'm ready. I'm not afraid to die, I'm afraid not to live fully. Because fully is to go deep. And for that, any challenge I take up.